Hello, my amazing friends and family. Welcome to today's video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I make this yummy, crunchy, fried fish. So delicious and very, very yummy. If you want to know how I make this yummy, delicious, crunchy, fried fish, stay tuned and keep on watching. If today is your first time of stopping by, you are highly welcome. For my old and new returning subscribers, you guys are highly appreciated. Thank you for clicking on this particular video. If you want to know how I make this yummy, crunchy, fried fish, stay tuned and keep on watching. For my fish, I'm going to be using Kpanla fish. Feel free to use any fish of your choice. So I've already washed and cleaned this fish and dried the excess water out of it. So this recipe, we don't need our fish to be so soggy, okay? We need to dry out all the water that is inside the fish, okay? So I've already dried and cleaned the water out. So what I'm going to be doing next, I'm going to be mixing all my ingredients that I'm going to be using to marinate my fish. In this bowl, I have some dry pepper, spicy, and salt. So I have my soya spice, okay? So this soya spice takes this fish to the next level. You can just imagine the taste of that soya spice in the fish. So delicious. Please, if you have soya spice, add it, okay? So I just added a quarter teaspoon of chicken seasoning. And I'm going to be adding a quarter teaspoon of garlic powder and a quarter teaspoon of ginger powder, okay? So I'm going to mix everything proper. I'll mix it together until everything is well combined, okay? So after mixing it proper, I will set it aside and I'll bring my fish to my work surface, okay? So as I wash the fish, I allow the fish to drain out water for like 20 minutes before making this video, okay? So that I will not have extra water in my fish. So you dry your fish proper before you start making your fried fish, okay? Before adding your marinade to it so that the marinade will penetrate inside your fish very well. So after adding my marinade to it, I'm going to be using my hand to rub it proper. So I'll just use my hand to massage everything on the fish, okay, so that everything will just penetrate inside the fish. All the seasoning, all the marinade will penetrate inside the fish proper, okay? So I'm just trying to make sure that all the marinades penetrate inside and outside the fish, okay, so that when we fry it, the fish will be very tasty. Okay, so that is what. So at this stage, I will start folding my fish. Okay, so if you don't want to fold your fish, you can as well cut it. Okay, just do it the way you want it to be or the way you want it to look like, okay? So if you don't want to fold it this way, you can swear cut it. Just do whatever you want to do with it, okay? You can swear cut it, you can swear fold it this way. So after putting my toothpick, I will just try and cut out the excess toothpick that is on it, okay? So as you can see how it look like after folding it, okay? So I have a video of how to make your dry fish, okay? So if you have not watched that video, I will leave the link on my description box and I'll also leave it on my comment section. Please do it to check it out, okay? So this one is fried method. So I have the oven method, okay? So if you have not watched that video, please do it to check it out. You will really love the way I make my fish, okay? You will love the method. So after folding it, this is how it looks like, okay? So beautiful. So I'm going to be arranging it on my oven tray, okay? So I will arrange it on my oven tray and I will allow it to sit for like 3 hours. So if you don't have the time, you can leave it for like 1 hour. So I just want it to dry out all the excess water that is on it, okay? So I'll just leave it for like 3 hours. What we need here is crunchy fried fish. So after frying it, so that your fish will be very crunchy. and tasty as well, okay? So I'll just leave it on my countertop for like 3 hours before we start frying. So guys, welcome back. This is after 3 hours, okay? So as you can see how dry my fish is. So this is exactly what I want, and the marinade has sit proper inside my fish. You can imagine after frying it how the taste will look like, guys. So delicious. Please try this method and you are really going to love your fried fish, okay? So the next thing I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be putting my oil in my frying pan and I'm going to be throwing one onions to it. So after throwing the onions, I will start making my fish. So first of all, I will use the dry flour to rub the fish so that any extra water that is on it will trap everything out. We are just trying to make sure that our fish is dry before frying it, okay? So I'll just use my flour to rub it proper before I'll start making my flour for frying, okay? Welcome back. In another bowl, I'm going to be adding my all-purpose flour, okay? So I'm going to be adding corn flour to it as well. So just make it depends the fish, the number of fish you have, okay? So I don't have the actual measurement, just make it the number of fish you have. So I just add 1/4 teaspoon of soya spice, dried pepper, chicken seasoning, garlic powder, and the nutmeg powder, okay? So I'm adding my spicy as well for extra flavor. So I'll just mix everything proper. I'll mix it proper so that everything will combine very well, okay? So I'll add a pinch of salt to it as well. Mix it proper, okay? So after mixing it, I'm going to be adding water to it. Add water bit by bit so that you don't have a very runny batter, okay? It's not too thick, it's not too light. We need a batter just like, need it like this. We don't need it to be very runny, okay? So this is my two flour, the dry and the wet one. First, we'll dip our fish inside the wet batter, okay? Make sure that you coat it proper, all right? Every part of the fish, okay? Make sure that it coats everything proper. Rub it well so that it will coat all the fish. Then after that, just make sure that you drain out the excess flour that is on it. As you can see me doing, I'll just dab it on my plate so that the excess flour will just went out. So I'll put it in the dry flour. Make sure that the dry flour coats all the fish proper as well, okay? So as you can see what I'm doing right now, I'll just make sure that all the dry flour coats the fish, then we start frying. So guys, you just fry your fish until it is well dry and crunchy on a medium heat, not very high, on a medium heat, all right?